the important thing that connects most stem cell scientists is the eventual hope that those basic things that you work on the lab every single day, at some point, could be translated in some benefit to a human patient. My name is Fernando Camargo, and I'm an associate professor at the stem cell program here at Boston Children's Hospital. And I'm also an associate professor at the Department of Stem Cell and Regenerative Medicine at Harvard University. I grew up in Arequipa, which is the second biggest city in Peru. My dad is an onion farmer, so I spent a lot of time at the farm. And I really think that just looking at nature, and I became curious. How were things constructed so they could work in a certain manner? My lab has been working on this group of genes called the hippo signaling path. After all the progress we have made in molecular and cellular biology, we really know very little about how an organ, say a liver, achieves a certain size and it stops growing once it's reached those dimensions. And symmetry, right? Why is your left hand the same size as your right hand? And what my lab has done was to actually test the effects of manipulating some of these genes, and we have figured out how that sensing might take place. We are tremendously excited about this, as it is one of the first windows that we have at how organ size and symmetry could actually be looked into. The most common cancers that you can think of, such as lung cancer, liver cancer, facial cancer, would be very strong candidates for hippo signaling activation. The other side of the coin is to achieve expanded growth in the petri dish. Take those cells from patients with fatal metabolic disorders, correct those mutations, and return those cells back to those patients. Initially, when I came to the States, I sort of struggled a bit. The only thing that I wish there would be more of is that I had interaction with Latino scientists. So, you know, my hope is that, you know, potentially try to be a role model, share my knowledge and the opportunities that I had, and to really train people so that, you know, they're the next generation of scientists.